Hi, and welcome back to JumpCloud's continuing video tutorial series. Today, we're going to discuss JumpCloud's latest release for system management, our MacOS app. We'll go through a live-fire exercise of how the system app works and the productivity gains your employees will receive by changing their password directly from within their operating system. Let's have a look. You can see here in front of you that there is a macOS endpoint. Our user today is a user by the name of Justin Boyle. He is a JumpCloud managed user. Let's enter in his creds. These are creds that were established by JumpCloud through the system agent that is currently deployed to this macOS system. On this employee system, you can see Justin has a Firefox browser opened. Justin is currently logged into various sessions of the services that he has access to, all being granted by JumpCloud. For example, this is the connectivity to his Google account. Another example is connectivity to Justin's Office 365 web portal. Furthermore, Justin actually has an account with Okta, which is being currently managed via JumpCloud's LDAP integration. And finally, of course, Justin has access at any time to the JumpCloud user portal. We're showing here SSO apps. In the case of using Okta, Justin and the company he works for would clearly be using Okta for many of those use cases as well for SAML-based assertion into various applications. But in this case, I have JumpCloud's portal open as well with some SAML apps. Now, before we dig into the exact password change, let's go and investigate something else. Let's go into JumpCloud here. This is the administrative portal. So I just switched to a Firefox view, and I want to take a look at Justin's account. So if we dip into Justin, we can see that the administrator, the JumpCloud administrator, has established him with a number of different resources. First and foremost, Justin has access to various user groups. You can see here, if we just show only the ones that he's bound to, we can sort of survey that this person, Justin, is probably a technical employee resource working against AWS development and production instances and all the resources that are connected to those user groups. We have systems. In this particular case, you can see that Justin has a MacBook. In fact, this is the Mac that I'm operating this demonstration from. So that's the current view that you're seeing, and that's the agent. The other systems are being granted access to Justin via those group memberships. They're up in the cloud, their servers up in the cloud. And most importantly, he has connectivity to these services. In fact, those are the ones I showed you on the original screen in the browser. The Google connectivity, Office 365, and Okta, again, being connected to JumpCloud through our LDAP endpoint. So with those resources understood, and with the fact that I have now, played the role of Justin, I've logged into my Mac, but most importantly, I have a current password sort of already hashed and distributed to all these endpoints. What do I have to do now in order, as Justin, to change my password? Welcome to the system app for macOS. You can see here at the top of the menu bar, in this particular case, the JumpCloud icon is seen. Let's assume that Justin needs to change his password. The only thing he'll need to do when notified is to open up the app. We will type in Justin's current password. I'm actually going to enter in a bad password here. So just so we can see some of the use cases in action, I'm going to be challenged for a multi-factor authentication code. This is due to the fact that Justin is governed by MFA with JumpCloud. But you can see I've entered in an invalid code. Let's give it a try again. Now you can see not only did I enter in the correct multi-factor verification code, but I didn't give it an appropriate password. So let me just adjust that. And I'll hit save. Again, I don't have the matching. So we will constantly be indicating to the end user, in this particular case, how the password needs to be constructed. So I've just gone through a couple of use cases there. Let's give it a whirl. And now we will submit that password back. And as you can see, the password is saved. So in this particular instance, what occurred? Instantly, this password was submitted back to JumpCloud, and through our credential management system, have distributed, literally dispersed the encrypted password hash to all of the endpoints immediately. Let's get out of this JumpCloud administrative portal. Now you can see we're back inside of Justin's world. Let's sign out as Justin. Let's re-sign in as Justin utilizing his brand new password, the one that I just gave to him. And we'll log in, and as you can see, success. The same thing here in the case of Office 365. We'll sign out, and obviously the pattern is all the same. The password hashes from JumpCloud's cloud-based directory service has been distributed to all of the endpoints. So again, we'll sign in, making sure he's appropriately logged in. Notice here that I'm not using the SAML protocol. I am utilizing straight up password based authentication, just simple authentication, just so you can see how this works from a password perspective. In the case of Okta, this is using, let me sign out here again. This is actually using the LDAP protocol. Okta is layered on top of JumpCloud's directory services in order to receive a basically an authoritative version of a password. This could be a similar or analogous to an Active Directory or an LDAP. Of course, you watching this video understand that by now we're sort of a new modern equivalent of those sort of legacy technologies. And as I'm demonstrating, we're walking through this sort of scenario of all the various resources immediately updated. I'm showing web services here, like web portals and properties, but also this can instantly provide access to the various systems and servers that Justin is currently provided access to, or back here in the case of JumpCloud's own portal, using our SAML-based assertions that password has been changed. We're using the SAML protocol. We have validated that Justin is who he is. And of course, you're seeing here Justin get asserted into, in this case, an AWS IAM session. So that is it. That is JumpCloud's initial release of our system password app. This is for macOS. The other operating systems, including Windows, is coming soon. And we'd enjoy your feedback as you start to utilize this in your production environments. Thanks for joining us today.